What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video, and we're gonna be talking about my camera gear setup for portraits and also weddings as well, but mainly what's inside my camera bag and all that good stuff using the Sony a7 III. So let's get to this video. Before we get started, I just wanna give a big shout out to our sponsors today, Briella and Joanna, because, well, they fell asleep and I can record these videos. So that's a good thing. It's a good thing. So what I wanna go over in this video specifically is what I carry with me on a portrait session slash engagement session. So if you're interested in what I actually take on a wedding day, let me know in the comments below so I can create a video for that specifically. Cause it's a little bit more in depth than just carrying this little bag. And there's more stuff to it, and it could just get crazy with everything here. So I have a few bags actually, and I'm really into camera bags. Now, depending on the type of day and what I'm actually gonna be shooting, it really depends on the bag that I'm gonna take. This is the Brevity Jumper. I just actually got this, was in December? And I like this bag. This bag is more like a backpack, so it's less discreet, doesn't look like your normal camera bag. So that's something that I want specifically when I'm out in like portrait sessions or I'm filming these BTS videos. And if you haven't seen any of them, I'm gonna link some down below in the cards, and you know, you check them out when you get a chance. So what I have hidden here is a few things that I like to take with me on a shoot, which one thing is my camera, which is the main thing. Sony a7 III with the Sigma 35-1.4 is what I have here currently set up right now. Now this lens is actually really sharp and I haven't had any issues with it. I know there's some people out there that maybe have had like bad copies of this lens. I'm not sure, but I haven't had any like focusing issues at the moment. And I'm planning on doing a few videos with this lens specifically and also testing out other 35 millimeter lenses, maybe different bodies. I am not sure. So let's just, you know, let's leave that for the future for you guys. And attached is this really awesome like bracket situation I have going on here. This is by the company YC Onion. If you don't know who they are, they're an awesome like manufacturer up, and you know, this bracket's like a half bracket, not a half cage, but it does have a quarter 20 threads there. And the really cool thing about this is that this plate, actually let me show you guys real quick, because that's what we're here for. The cool thing about this specific plate is not only does it give you like an extension, like a grip, but also depending on what you're doing, if you're doing video related stuff, or if you want to have some extra space for like a microphone, like a Rode, you know, Wireless Go or something like that, or even a monitor or a light, you can extend the side here. You have options here to do a few things, and I'm planning on doing like kind of like a monster rig when it comes to one of my BTS videos. So hopefully I do that, and yeah, you guys get to see that. Oh, not to even mention, wait until the end of this video because we're actually doing a giveaway. So if you have a Sony a7 III, you can win one of these. So wait until the end of the video. In this bag also, I have a few lenses, and it's pretty cool because there's enough space in here to put a few lenses with the camera body. So I have here 85-1.8 from Sony. If you haven't used any of the 85 millimeters from Sony, 85 millimeter 1.4 G Master is an amazing lens. It's a little bit more expensive, but this 85-1.8 is a small form factor. It's a lightweight. It's still built nicely, and the great quality that comes out of it. Now, you can't beat it for the price. It's pretty, I really dig it. If I need a shallow depth of field and I'm shooting these type of videos, I go with the 16 1.4. Not too long ago, I shot a wedding and I decided to use the 16 1.4 for this more landscape type, portrait type situation. And yeah, check it out right here. So hopefully you like it. And yeah, got that with the 16 millimeter 1.4 from Sigma. The other lens, which is like more of my tried and true lens, and I always use it. And it's something that is weird because I like shooting primes. But as far as zoom goes, this is the only zoom lens I have, and I don't think I can see myself other than like, well, the 17 to 28 is an amazing lens from Tamron. But this is the 28 to 75 from Tamron. This lens has been with me for the past year, and I've been using it constantly. Now, the cool thing about this lens is I do have coverage from 28 millimeters to 75 millimeters and at 2.8. So I do still get like that shallow depth of field. Haven't had any issues with this lens at all. For the most part, this is the go-to zoom lens for me. There are a ton of zoom lenses out there, 16-35 G Master lenses, but for me, the price and the quality that you get and the sharpness that you get from this lens, I mean, you can't beat it. I actually have a few videos out in my channel that you see me shooting with this, so I'm gonna link them down below or in the card up. You guys can check them out later. I'll make sure to link everything down below so you guys can check it out. These are pretty much my lenses. I don't have a wide variety of lenses. have an 85, the 35, and the 20-75. The other lens I'll probably want to get is the 17-28. So just in case I don't want to use my 16mm and I want to have multiple like ranges and I have the options to do that, the 17-28 makes more sense. The next set of things I like to take with me in either a portrait session or an engagement session is light. I do like to shoot natural light, but I actually like to shoot with strobes and flash and get creative with light and all that. And I think it's just really fun. And it's really cool to actually use both styles depending on the client. And I think what happens is that when you're able to shoot in both styles, you know, you can give your client like variety, especially on a wedding day or even an engagement session or a portrait session. So in this bag, I'm able to carry one, and actually I could put two in here, but for right now I have one 8200. So the one 8200 from Godox, I love these little lights. I mean, 200 watts of power, you can't beat it. There are others out there, like the 400. There's actually, I think, like a 300 coming out. So yeah, I mean, for me, man, this is like pretty awesome. And oh, it's still on. Is this on? I smell something. I think I burnt. No, it works. Okay, cool. All right, turn. Okay, all right, I have this huge flash thing right here. Yeah, I can see you. Godox 8200, this is an amazing light. My eyes hurt so bad right now. So when I first started, I only had one of these, and now lately I've been shooting with either two of these and put it together in the dual head system so it can create 400 watts of power, or I take my big boy out here. Let me just put this over here. And have is the 8600. So 600 watts of power, you can't go wrong with this. I mean, there are other units out there, and I got a really sweet deal on this during Christmas. So now I have more power and I can get more creative. Now I can pair this with, you know, one or two of these flashes to do more creative lighting, especially outside situations, and knowing that I can overpower the sun when I need to. But depending on the shoot, I take specific types of modifiers with me. I have an Easy Lock 34 inch beauty dish that I have, and I've actually used that in a few shoots. And I'll link everything down below as well for you guys. I also carry with me the 38 inch globe parapop, which is what I'm using right now to diffuse my face with the light. So this is kind of, I just wanted to show you guys what I use specifically on a portrait session. I don't necessarily have to take all these lenses with me on a shoot. Sometimes I honestly take maybe two. Maybe I take the 35 and the 85 and that's it. Or I might just get the 20-75 and just be good with the 85. Feel fancy, I'll take all four if anything, but you know, it really depends again on the type of shoot that I'm going for. The very last thing I want to talk about is an actual giveaway that I'm doing with YC Onion. We're actually going to be giving away this specific bracket for the Sony A7 III. I know, it's for only the Sony A7 III. However, you know, if you have one and you want to get this bracket, just follow the rules down below. Pretty much subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, and follow me on Instagram and YC Onion on Instagram. And then we'll, you know, pick you up randomly in a random generator. I might even do a live on Instagram, who knows? But I'll let you guys know more details when I actually make the announcement. The other product we're going to be giving away from YC Onion is actually really awesome. It's like a quick release plate that goes on your camera and under your camera. It's like a universal thing. It was just pretty dope. It's called the Peach. If you've never seen this before, this is an awesome little product. What happens is that you put this at the bottom of your camera, and for the most part, you can use this on any like any other tripod, and it has a screw, and then you just kind of twist and turn and release it. It's a pretty cool little quick release plate. It's actually really heavy duty and actually works really, really well. I've done some tests on it just to test it out, but you're gonna get this also. So you're gonna get the bracket and this quick release plate from YC Onion. And yeah, thanks YC Onion for giving me this stuff to check it out. Before I let you guys go, let me know in the comments below what kind of camera gear are you actually interested in seeing coming out soon. We have some really cool things happening with Canon and Fuji, and I'm really excited to see where the industry is going to be going with all the camera gear and all that stuff. Thanks for watching this video, guys, and if you haven't yet, hit that subscribe button below, give it a thumbs up, because it does help the channel out, helps this video do all the algorithm kind of cool stuff. Stay awesome, stay fresh, keep creating.